Hello, everyone. After I starting network system, so now resistance is the first topic. Suppose that this is resistance. How can I define resistance? One second, this is the resistance. In the case of resistance, current always flows from high to lower potential. High potential, suppose that this is 5 volt and this is 3 volt. The current always flow to 5 to 3 volts. Okay? Mean I is equal to 5 minus 3 divided by something to be resistance over. Suppose that R. It means always there, this is greater than 0. This current is flowing this one, this direction. And this is minus 2. And this is minus 5. Corridor flow minus 2 this plus 5 divided by something current as positive here. This is greater than 0 because this, understand about that, the current to resistance current always flow to higher to lower potential. In case first problem is V is equal to I R, so V is equal to I R, this is I R, the current going this direction, and the potential, this is plus I R. Current is same direction, while in second case both current and potential are opposite to each other. Suppose that voltage across this resistance is plus and minus. V dash, so V R dash this is equal to blah, 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 minus I R, where R is the rho and R is rho kya resistivity, which has its unit appear ohm into meter with him. It's opposed to the conductivity. We already studied in class 12 also. Where L is the length of conductor, A is the area of conductor, resistance always dissipate power, does not store any energy. So power jo hota hai, koi energy store nahi karta. Power store any resistance is always equal to zero. Matlab jo power hogi resistance ki value kya milegi, zero milegi. Ye koi bhi energy store nahi karta, balki ye kya karta hai, dissipate karta hai. Okay. आगे हम पढ़ेंगे कि इस एक्चुअल में ये ठीक कैसे होती है, तो हम पावर से डिस्कशन करेंगे। तो फिलहाल इसमें हम देखिए कि रेजिस्टेंस डज नॉट स्टोर एनी एनर्जी, इट्स ऑलवेज डिसिपेट। तो नाउ इधर का फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ now study on resistance. If two resistance are series, suppose that two resistance, this one and this one, this is R1, this is R2, they are connected. Current are flowing this one, voltage across this, plus minus, this is plus minus, I, this is V1 and this is V2. Total resistance across, suppose that can be this voltage, this is equal to V1 plus V2. V1 is equal to I into R1 and V2 is equal to I into R2. And V is the, suppose that equivalent resistance across this whole circuit is R equivalent. I R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. It means if two resistance are connected in series R1 and R2, then equivalent resistance is equal to R1 plus R2. How can we have this? It's a very useful result. Okay. Suppose that this is R3 and also connect R4 and so on. Then equivalent resistance across this one is R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R1. Okay. Now next, this is the series, this series resistance. Now this is the now let's discuss to the parallel resistance. What is the effect of the parallel? Suppose that this is R1, this is R1, this is R2. If both are parallel, then voltage across R1 and R2 is V. But current is different. This is I1, this is I2. Suppose this is I. Equivalent resistance across the whole circuit is R equivalent. Suppose that this is the voltage across this is V. What is I? I this is equal to add this mode. I1 plus I2. I this is equal to RV upon R equivalent, and I1 is equal to V upon R1 and V upon R2. Then R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. This is the basic. If another resistance are connected in parallel, this is R3, R4 and R5 and all such.